Hey guys, Uncle Jim from Trek Talkin', a Star Trek podcast, back with a review of Star Trek Discovery. This week, I'm looking at the second episode of Season 2, New Eden. Warning, this video does contain spoilers, so if you have not seen this episode, please come back and check out this video after you've watched the episode. Thank you, and enjoy. Season 2 of Star Trek Discovery continues with New Eden, directed by Jonathan Frakes, written by Akia Goldsman and Sean Cochran. Original air date, January 24th, 2019. Jonathan Frakes had a special visitor on set with him during filming. Does she look familiar to you? We ran a poll on our Facebook page asking fans if they were happy to have Frakes back in the director's chair again. As you can see, 96% voted yes. Jonathan Frakes has directed two Star Trek Discovery episodes so far, with a third one on the way. We also ran a poll asking our Facebook fans what episode they liked the best. As you can see, 56% picked New Eden. In this episode, a new signal appears, prompting Stamets' emotional return to the mycelial network and leading Berman, Pike, and Oshagun to a pre-warp planet, Terra Elysium, where they face a complex ethical dilemma. Tilly's over-eagerness lands her in trouble, but when the planet and Discovery's landing party are threatened, her curiosity may be the one thing that can save them. I really like what Pike has done with Lorca's ready room. He made it brighter, added chairs, and a table for staff meetings. Now that the first two episodes have aired, we ran a poll on our Facebook page and asked fans what their favorite episode was. 72% picked New Eden as their favorite. Rather than me talking about the episode, I'm going to show some clips of my favorite scenes.
And it's in the Beta Quadrant, 51,450 light years away.
At top speed, that would take us 150 years to get that far. My unborn children's children would be lucky to get their ideas.
The Spore Drive. But until a non-human interface is found, Starfleet has decommissioned it, or its navigator, really.
In order to guide us through the mycelial network, Commander Stamets injected himself with tardigrade DNA, a violation of Starfleet's ban on genetic manipulation.
They were willing to overlook this during the war, however.
A tardigrade?
I suppose you had to be there.
Getting to the bottom of these signals is of utmost importance to the Federation. They let you use the drive to fight the Klingons. They'll give us dispensation now. How long before it can be operational?
Once I begin prepping Commander Stamets, 20 minutes.
Get to it.
Spore drive is ready, Captain.
Questions or concerns before we depart, Captain?
If you're telling me that this ship can skip across the universe on a highway made of mushrooms, I kind of have to go in faith.
Be bold.
Be brave.
Be courageous. Black alert.
All personnel, black alert.
Let's jump.
Forget your first, sir.
Yeah, here looks promising. Okie dokie. Activating laser core sampler and corresponding internal artificial grav. After putting my calculations, one cubic centimeter of symmetry uncharged asteroid weighs in at a portly 1.5 metric tons. Metrion fluctuation detected.
Clearly, that distress beacon has been broadcasting without these people even knowing it. We'll turn it off so no one else disturbs this place and then beam out.
I isolated a distress beacon signal. It's coming from down here.
Let's hope that helmet camera's down here too.
I'm sorry, sir. You can't be suggesting that we leave them here.
Find that beacon, please, Awoshikin.
Before we transport it down, you said you had a hunch. The signal we were following was leading us to a rescue mission.
No one needs rescuing, Burnham. This place really is a new Eden.
Amisha and the others are kin to us. They deserve to be reintegrated into modern society.
By their own account, they left Earth in 2053. They did not use a starship. That makes them pre-warp, subject to General Order 1. We cannot interfere with their natural development.
We ran a poll on our Facebook page asking fans what they thought about New Eden. As you can see, 93% of the fans gave it a thumbs up score, making this the highest rated Discovery episode of the season so far.
Wherever our mission takes us, we'll try to have a little fun along the way too, huh? Make a little noise, ruffle a few feathers.
Thank you for watching. Please visit our Facebook page, Trek Talking and Beyond, and don't forget to vote in our polls. Listen to Trek Talking live every Thursday night at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Blog Talk Radio. We can also be found on iTunes and Odyssey Radio. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more, you can show your support by becoming a patron at patreon.com/trektalking. Kapla!